What's up, everybody? It's your boy Blackbeard, and I'm here with another video. Today we have a Reddit post made by Crashy. I feel like this is a very good post on what does the community want as a wish list. It's just little things that, you know, the community might want, or the users and the players might want to kind of make the game better in their opinion. So let's go over what some of the player base have said, and I kind of get a review, or, you know, pretty much state my opinions on if I agree or disagree with what they say. Let's go get it started. So my name is Crashy, and I'm a Unite content creator. I was hoping I could call on the community to write up some of their items for a Pokemon Unite wishlist. I'm curious what the community feels the game needs and or would like to see change. Y'all down? I'm down. I personally want to see changes to the rank mode matchmaking, as well as more frequent or better patch notes for balance changes. All right. So, what is this guy's name? Lily Maru. I think the game can use more socks. It's a little bit of a troll post, as you guys can see. The game has a lot of socks to me. Personally, I'm not really a cosmetic type of person, so they add more socks, they don't add more socks. Your boy is fine. Tencent, Pokemon, do what you want. Let's see, your ideas are too small to think outside the socks. Got it. Biggest thing I'd like to see in matchmaking, at least, is separate queues for pre-made and solo. This, I completely agree with. I've always said from the jump that this game should definitely separate solo queue and pre-made, or at least solo and duo. Solo and duo should all be playing together, and pre-made three and five should be in pre-made, and that should be its own queue. Completely. Solo and duos, that should all be its own queue, and that would kind of separate the confusion. I would even go as far to say make it its own rank. So if you're trying to get masters, you have to get masters in two places. You gotta get masters in rank, I mean solo, and solo and duos, and you have to get masters in pre-mades. That'll make the game a lot more better for certain people who might not have friends to play with. Again, this is all my opinion. All right, so something I would love to see is something on a Pokemon screen to clearly indicate a Pokemon stats. It's cool we have stuff like score speed, but knowing like if a Pokemon benefits from muscle bands, attack buff, or the wise glasses special attack buff in game would be amazing. Similarly, knowing that a specific defender is better at dealing with special attackers like Gengar or Melee, attackers like Garchomp would also be beneficial. Hiding this info just seems like a weird choice to me. I didn't realize Gengar was a special attacker or Blissey was until later, and I think it would help players a lot knowing that info. Again, I agree. I've actually made a whole 20-minute video talking about this. The game, but I noticed this with most Pokemon games, or just Nintendo games, period. The game has a lot of hidden stuff that it doesn't tell you, and I think that it needs to do a better job telling us the stats, the direct information and info, what's good, what's bad, what not to do with a certain Pokemon, and what to do with a certain Pokemon. I've always said that this is a huge problem, and the lack of detail and information regarding this game is just kind of insane to me. So, what is this guy's name? Mixie Slaw. I agree. I'll give you a thumbs up for this one, because I've also made a video on this, and I don't like how certain things are hidden inside the game. Please fix that. better, more meaningful ranked rewards, more frequent balance updates, communication on why changes were made. Absolutely agree. Absolutely agree. If we can just get more information, just a lot more information on the updates. I feel like the updates are very vague and there's like no real explanation why certain things have changed, certain things were nerfed or buffed, bug fixes. Some of these bugs, I didn't even know it was an issue, to be honest with you. So I also agree with this guy. As far as meaningful ranked rewards, agree again, because once you get all your items to a certain level, especially all the items that you use to, like, let's say max level, the item sort of doesn't mean anything. Like, the rewards are kind of useless after a while. Kinda. The rewards are useless after a while, and that definitely needs to be fixed immediately. So let's go get that changed. It'll help a lot. Nintendo, thank you. So I'm gonna give this guy a thumbs up. Captain's mode, mode with sequential bands and picks for each item, for each team, as a ranked mode option. Also, more held items buffed to existing held items. All right, so this guy just wants a draft pick. I don't think anybody that's competitive would disagree with this. This game is in desperate need of a draft pick. This game, it needs a draft pick sooner than later. I feel like the meta is very, very stale right now because everyone uses the same Pokemon. And if certain things just get banned up front, it'll cause a lot of like confusion and a lot of, you know, it just kind of creates, right now the game needs draft picks because right now it's just too stale. In order for you to win ranked right now, you have to use pretty much the same Pokemon, the same 7 Pokemons out of a 20 roster game. And draft picks will make it to where everyone has to pick different Pokemons. And certain Pokemons are also banned, meaning that you have more strategy on counter picks and what you're picking and how to counter certain Pokemon. So I agree with this guy, definitely. Change this. Also, more held items buff to existing held items. Nah. I agree with the second half. A lot of the items definitely needs to be buffed. A lot of the items in this game definitely needs to be buffed, because I would say about 75% of the items in this game are pointless. There's no point in running it. So let's go to Cloudy Reef's post. I think what I want above all else right now is some of the more persistent and annoying bugs removed. Things like Slowbro telekinesis not working 50% of the time. I agree. 90% against Ninetales. I agree. I was actually using Slowbro the other day and telekinesis just doesn't work more often than not. It's kind of crazy. Unite moves being canceled back to zero without even activating. Agrees. This is the most annoying thing ever. I hate this right now. If they can fix the fact that especially when you're playing against Wigglies, my ult being canceled because Wigglies passive activated is toxic, is super toxic. Please fix this. All right, next one by NoodleDoodle21, matchmaking fixes. The fact that master players can be queued with veterans is beyond me. And honestly, how many bad players are in the higher up ranks? So this I do agree with. I don't think that veterans, the matchmakings in this game do need to be fixed. It definitely needs to be fixed. I don't think that veterans should be playing masters players. The only people that should be playing with masters is ultras. That's it. I feel like it should only be one level up or something around that. So like beginner should only be playing experts, experts should only be playing with beginner and vets, beginner and elite, etc., etc. So they need to do something about matchmaking, because right now it's very unbalanced. And don't even get me started with standard. Standard is horrible right now. I feel like standard is pretty much unplayable. Next one, all battle items being equally valuable. For the most part, eject button goal getter is probably the means, and means an increase or decrease in cooldown. For others, X attack and potion, I think this would be a mean for reworking of how the item actually behaves. Like if, say, X attack added a percentage to your final damage output rather than your attack stat, and if potion increased your HP by a greater percentage. I agree to disagree with this. Again, I'm all for buffing items. Probably about 80% of the items in this game needs buffs. There's only like four viable items in this game, maybe five, probably like four and a half viable items in this game. So yes, I agree. Please buff the items in this game, because most of them is borderline useless. Make the score viewable at all times. I don't know about all times, but I do think instead of having phrases to kind of gauge where you're at, I feel like every minute they should show the actual score. This, if you're gonna have phrases to show us the score every minute, probably not all the time, but every minute, show us the exact score, call it a day. Separate queues for solo players and teams. Agrees, I already went over that. I do think that solo players and teams and comp needs to go be playing in different type of rank modes. Increase the cap on daily and weekly coin earnings. Super agree with that. The fact that we're capped daily is horrible to me. Please, let's increase the cap. I understand you want people to spend money on the game, but I feel like where we're at right now, which I believe is 2,100, the 2,100 is either like, I think that's a week. I feel like that's way too low, especially someone like me that plays the game pretty decently. I play the game a lot. The hidden score is intentional to promote less puppy guarding of goals, which I do agree. That's exactly why I don't want the game to show the score at all times. So I do think that instead of just showing us the phrase, just either show us the exact points of where we're at, or at least give us the range, like show us a number range, because I'm not gonna lie, I don't remember what's what. So it could be more definite and decisive of what we're doing. All right, my wish list, Megastone battle item, 90 seconds, raises all of your stats until you faint. You cannot score goals while this item is active. You cannot activate this battle item unless you're fully evolved. You can toggle off this effect if activated again. Cooldown starts after the effect is toggled off or if you faint. This actually sounds sort of good. I actually like this Megastone battle item. I like this. I would like to see this, definitely. Changes to battle items, slow smoke 40 seconds, create a ring of smoke around you, greatly slowing enemies within and their attack speed for 2 seconds. Attack speeds, slow duration, 1 second, 2 seconds, got it. Roll queue, choose to queue as top, center, or bottom. For ranked, I think this is a definite. This needs to happen for ranked. I feel like Pokemon needs to do something like Overwatch, where they give us what the meta is and they force us into roles. I feel like that this will make the game, or at least ranked, a lot more playable and better. But again, only do this for ranked. Don't do this for standard. Ban and draft, one ban per team followed by yes. agrees. Solo dual K team, separate queues, yeah, self-explanatory, I agree. Clan system, create a unique team name and invite up to 10 players into the group. Players that are in the group make queue together as a team and earn unique and exclusive rewards on the ranked team leaderboards. I agree, we could do that. This is just something for fun, especially for people that play comp a lot. Like me, I play comp a lot. So yes, I agree with this. Ranked matchmaking fixes. Players can only queue with or against players one rank or above their current rank. Agrees. That's pretty much what I said earlier. Change that to this, and I think ranked would be a little better. Consistent level power spikes until Unite move. Learn at level 9, not 8, 10. Final evolution at 9 and not 10 like guard. Agrees. Let's go make it the standard. If you're a 3 evolution, make it your last level at level 9. So it goes from 5, 9. So you get to your second evolution at level 5, your third evolution at level 9. I agree with that. Score is not shown in game. I don't like this. I see where you're going with this, but I don't think that the score should be shown throughout the entire game. Now that I'm really thinking about it. Let's change that to it shows up every minute, or they change the phrases to where it makes more sense of where each team is at. Zapdos buff, insta score, 80% scoring speed. That's decent. I feel like if you want to go boost Zapdos buff, let's change it to where the game removes double scoring at the 2 minute mark, and remove insta scoring from Zap, and make it to where when you kill Zapdos, you'll get like a 50% scoring speed, and you get double points. Change it to that. So make it to where Zapdos is giving you double points and increasing your scoring speed by a little bit. Not instant, but a little bit. And I think that fixes a lot of things. Introduce Moltres and Articuno. I agree. Please, let's do this. I think we need other evolutions, which I think we'll probably end up doing. I think we'll get other legendaries for an objectives as the game progresses. So we'll see where that goes. Jungle changes, the aggro range for Ludicolo and Buffalo Ant is greatly reduced. If they are pulled out of these zones, they will reset and fully regenerate their health. Damage is greatly increased. Health is agrees. Please, let's do this. This will make jungling a lot more harder to do at earlier levels. So I do condone this. This is to help remove range attackers from jungle, since they can't sit behind the cove and kill both mons without a single damage. Agrees. Killing a wild jungle mon will no longer restore health. I actually agree with this, because this will also stop range attackers from going into the jungle. Fluffy Tail restores health after fainting a wild jungle mon. Agrees. Let's go add that. Changes like this will make speedsters and all arounders the main junglers, instead of how it is right now, where it's pretty much just ranged attackers, ranged ADCs, and including add Blastoise to that list. And there you go, is really only Greninja and Blastoise at this point of time that's valuable junglers right now. Let's see. This makes, all right, so stores, okay, yeah, got it. All right, so let's go down, let's see what this guy is saying. Matchmaking, choose role, speedsters, defender, support, all arounder. Agrees. Please force us into roles for ranked. I think that would change a lot of things in this game. Choosing lane is mandatory. Agrees. Please let us choose a lane. Please let us choose a lane on the character select screen. Make that mandatory. Text chat, custom shout out in lobby, custom ping text, ping support, touch control, auto upgrade skill. All of these I agree with. I think if we are able to set our how we level up our moves and our move choices, that'll be better, definitely, for some people. Probably at higher levels, the higher level players won't use this because different builds are probably better depending on what's the enemy's team comps. For example, Blissey, if you're playing against a team that has a ton of CC, Safeguard is better. If you're playing a team that only has like one character that has CC, then Softboiled is better. Aim move support, touch control. I support that. Score announcer, show last score announce text when pressed to see their team info. Change the gap of score to make it more useful. 0 to 20 point difference, it's a close battle. 21 to 99 difference, we're in the lead, we're struggling to keep up. 100 point difference, we have a huge lead, we're really struggling. That's what it is currently. And he suggests changing to 0 to 29. You're within one full dunk. I like that better. That makes more sense. 30 to 99, you're within one full double score points. That makes it more obvious too as well, because it's saying that we're in one full double score dunk. Okay. 100 to 299. Better farm up faster, take defense. Zapdos. This could be reworded a little bit differently, but I get what he's saying. I like it. And add 300 plus difference, must take Zapdos to turn around or the whole team farm up. Oh, this is a little bit too long. Yeah, this needs something shorter. But yeah, let's make it to make all these sayings make more sense. And once you read it, you understand what it's saying. I think the game should have more Cramorant. That is a definitely troll post. And last guy, an easier way to navigate around the starting menu feels clunky. Oh man, the menu in this game is horrible. It's very laggy, very clunky, slow. This guy's correct. Please, let's do something about the menu. The menu in this game is horrible. It's horrid. Better customizable options for our character cards and backgrounds. Agrees. Right now, I feel like the card customization is ass. Please just fix that. A way to have your favorited Pokemon as your first pick, or a way to change order of Pokemon when choosing Pokemon. I agree. This needs to be done sooner than later. Definitely sooner than later. I would want my favorite Pokemon to be my auto pick. Draft mode for ranked. I think everybody wants this. If you're a real competitor in this game, you want this draft mode sooner than later. But I understand that there isn't a lot of Pokemon to choose from, so draft can't happen yet. But once there's a decent amount of Pokemon, once I say there's 5 different Pokemons for each role, please, let's have draft picks, because 5 Pokemons for each role. There's 5 roles in the game right now. That's 25 Pokemons. You have 5. I feel like that's enough for a draft. That's more than enough for a draft. Matchmaking is an issue since no consistency in quality of players, especially in ranked. Part of the issue are the performance points bot matches. I'm not gonna lie. No matter what they do regarding solo queue, you're not, most of the time you're gonna think that the quality of players is garbage. There's nothing you could do about that. There's no fix for that. You play the game, you play solo queue a lot. Most matches you're gonna feel like your teammates are garbage. It is what it is. That's MOBAs in general. Solo dual queue should be separated from queue. Agrees. Need more consistent balance patches with more detailed patch notes. 100% agrees. The patch notes right now are definitely lacking info. I think Zapdos is fine, but I might be in the minority. Zapdos do need some changes. I mean, it's like I'm sort of fine with Zapdos, but something got to get toned down with Zap to where it does take some skill. They can't just auto win with it. Still make it like very, very strong, but don't make it like a auto win, borderline auto win functionality. You can still win if the enemy team takes Zap, but like 9 times out of 10, you're gonna lose if the enemy team takes Zap. Get rid of MVP and rank participation daily missions. Agrees. Let's remove that. Only reason why I say I remove that is because if you main something like a support character, most of the time you're not gonna get MVP. That's just how the game is. They're not gonna get MVP at all if you're a support main. And maybe even a tank main, you're not gonna get MVP. So that's it, guys. This is my opinion on the Reddit Crashy post that Crashy made. This is the community wish list. I hope you guys enjoyed everything. If you guys have any questions or concerns, or you know, just your opinions, just please write it down in the comment sections. It's your boy Blackbeard, and I hope you enjoy the video. Please like, subscribe, and hit that bell button for your boy. I also stream on Twitch. I also stream on Twitch Monday, Wednesday, Friday from 7 to 10 Central. So please slide through. All my information is down in the description. It's your boy Blackbeard, and I'm out. Peace. Aha! I'm out.